Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 22nd annual 16-inch Softball Hall of Fame. And now we'd like to greet our announcer. He's the big bopper, the Sultan of SWAT, Mr. Clutch, the man of the hour with all the power, George Bliss.
Hi, everybody. How's everything going tonight? Okay, look at this. 2-2, the 22nd annual 16-inch Softball Hall of Fame at beautiful Drury Lane. We have an incredible staff tonight. Theo McClendon in the audio booth, and of course, that video. Let's have a big hand for Al Mag, who put that video together. Al Mag. Of course, I am George Bliss, and I was inducted in 1876, and it's a long time ago, but I really love doing this. We're going to have a lot of fun tonight, just a couple little things quickly. Our main aisle here, our camera aisle, during the broadcast right now, kind of stay out of the aisle, and just if you're outside, come on out and sit down that way, but keep this aisle clear. And more than that, if you want to take pictures, no problem. Stand right over there, or right over there, and get your people. And then after the people are introduced with the great Ronnie Kubicki, we get a still picture anyway. So we got plenty of time. It's your show. It's your softball game. Now, can I ask you please to rise, remove your hats, and we're going to honor the greatest country in the world, the United States, with our national anthem. Theo? Come on, big applause for the greatest country in the world. Come on, you can do better than that. All right. Well, during the night, we're going to have Mary Pat come up a few times, and a few other people, we're going to talk a little bit. But before we bring up Mary Pat, this is maybe my 10th or 12th year up here, and we have the greatest president of any nonprofit in Illinois. I really believe that. So I'm going to bring him up now, bring up the music, Theo. Let's bring up the great, great guy. He's won more games last year than the Cubs have in 100 years. Bring up Hawaii, you got it. The great! Round of applause for Ron Kubicki, our president, Ronnie Kubicki. Play that salsa music, baby.
As I get older, I need glasses. Please apologize for that. Part of my job as president is to kind of give this is our Hall of Fame dinner, and I like to welcome everybody here, but I also have to give you kind of the rundown of how we did this year as a Hall of Fame. So again, I'd like to congratulate all the new inductees this year. Fantastic class. I think our system's starting to work even better each year. Every one of them is deserving, and I think it's a great class. I also want to thank our board members. Ray Topps, Mark Figetto, Stan Paddock, Al Magg, Jeff Berger, John Doss, Paul Rowan, Fritz Zimmerman, Mike Coleman, Bill Cavanaugh, Frank Lantine, Tommy Lantine, Sherman Martin, George Vanilius, Curtis Grandison Sr., Chris Downs, and Austin Ware. Guys, if you're there, stand up one. These guys put a lot of time in over the year. And if I can, too, just a side note, when you go to bed tonight, maybe most of you out there know Stan Paddock. Stan's one of our board members, and he's going through a real tough time right now. And saw him the other day, and he's very positive, but things aren't really looking really, really good. And just keep him in your prayers if you could. Stan's a great guy, great coach, a class act, and I love the man. And just we'll say a little prayer later on, but maybe tonight if you could say a little prayer for Stan. I also want to thank Rachel. You out there? Stand up there. Rachel's the one you talked to on the phone. She's our administrative assistant. She's going to have some special surgery done in a week, 2 weeks. Pray for Rachel, too. We love you. She does a great job for us. I want to thank also George Bliss for being our MC, Bill Waddington and Chris Downs for helping put the book together that you have out there. Those guys did a fantastic job. Up on the wall, you're going to see the picture. We lost four of our Hall of Famers last year. Great people. One of the inductees that we're going in this year, we lost her just a week ago. We're going to miss her, but we want to remember them. So if you can, let's take a moment of silence and remember them. Thanks. I know they're down the big softball diamond upstairs looking down on us right now. One of the big changes, as you saw, this is the 50th anniversary of Forest Park No Glove Nationals. One of the greatest tournaments of all time, one of the greatest fields of all time, one of the greatest staffs of all time. These guys are incredible. I've been in the Park District myself for 40 years. Nobody matches these guys, and I love them to death. The table's right back there. Guys, stand up, Forest Park. Dave Novak, Larry Pykars. Larry's retiring in October. Fantastic organization. But what we're doing this year is we always have our inductee day. It used to be always on a Saturday. We're going to start it this year because of the 50th anniversary. We're going to start the Hall of Fame week on a Tuesday night. So our inductee night is going to be on a Tuesday night, and that's going to kick off the 50th anniversary of the tournament. Our golf outing is going to be on Friday, September 14th. I wanted to get that out there. We have some, as you come in today, we have some new products that we want to let all the Hall of Famers that are in the audience and those new ones coming. The shadow box up here, if you're interested in that, come and see me. We have forms for that for your, if you want to take something home for you for the plaques. In the back of the books, if you know somebody out there you think belongs in the Hall of Fame, we all think we know everybody. There's forms, criteria, everything's in the back of the book. It explains why we do it, how we do it. I know I get a lot of calls telling me, I believe I belong in the Hall of Fame. And when I show them the criteria, they say, well, maybe I don't. So read the criteria, and it kind of spells everything out. And finally, I want to go over some of the accomplishments that we did this year. I think it's the 11th year, we do a joint class with DePaul University. Usually in August, end of August, beginning of September, new freshmen coming into DePaul University don't know anything about Chicago, they don't live here. We bring them out to the Hall of Fame, we teach them 60 inch softball. And when you see these kids come in, and I have to thank Forest Park for that too, because they let us use their fields. You see these kids come in, and George will tell you, Frank Lantine, who was a big help of us, our Austin was there, JD was there this year. You see on their face, like, excuse my language, ladies, what the hell am I doing here? At the time we get done with the clinic, we can't get them off the field. They love the game that much. So I think we're doing a good job with that. I want to thank Austin. I got the list here. Frank Lantine, George, Ray Topps, Fritz Zimmerman. This year, we worked with the Chicago Police Department again, and Bill Cavanaugh, too, to help underprivileged kids and kids that are in trouble. We go down there and do a clinic for them. It's been on Channel 7, ABC. They showed it both years, so that's a good job. I think the Hall of Fame is spreading the word of 16 softball. We have a lot of publicity this year. We were rated the sixth spot in Chicago, a must-see by Chicago Magazine, also by the Chicago Tribune. Our museum's getting some notoriety. And about 3 weeks ago, we were on WGN, and we're going to show you that little clip right now. It only takes a couple of minutes. We were on WGN where they come out and did a tour of the Hall of Fame.
Okay, the North Side and South Side are definitely rivals, but when it comes to softball, it's 16-inch all the way, baby. So I'm about to get the history of the game. Hey, how are you? I'm Dawn.
I'm Ryan Kubicki, president of softball. Welcome.
The 16-inch Softball Hall of Fame is a museum that honors softball's rich history.
All softball started here in 1887 at the Farragut Yacht Club. So we own the game. 16-inch softball is Chicago, barehanded, blue collar. Well, it's the greatest game that ever could be played because anybody can play this game.
How did you come up with this Hall of Fame?
There was a gentleman called Al Magg, and it was his dream to keep our game alive. He, back in 1996, decided, why don't we start a Hall of Fame?
When you hear Ron talk about this Hall of Fame, you can see the passion written all over his face. I saw a timeline that I would love to go check out around the corner.
Before you do that, I'd like to put a hat on you because you're going to become a Hall of Famer already.
I love that.
Hi, I'm George Bliss, and I'm a media member of the 16-inch Softball Hall of Fame. How about this? 131 years ago, 1887, at the Farragut Boat Club, two guys got bored and they took a boxing glove, wrapped up a string and tossed it, and somebody took a broomstick and hit it, and thus the great sport of 16-inch was begun. We get into the 30s during the Depression. Remember, a lot of people didn't have money then.
Money was tight, right? And so this game really picked up momentum, and just thousands upon thousands of people would watch it and play because all you needed was a bat and a ball.
12,000 people showed up at every single game at parks like Kelly Park on the famous South Side.
Now, what are we coming up on here?
These are some real historical uniforms. Look at these, 1939, 1940. These are the actual uniforms that were worn.
They literally wore these uniforms in winning games. These are historic.
Now, who wears cool pants like this?
That's exactly right. Who wears cool pants like this?
Dawn, if you're going to be a big softball star like I know you are, you have to have a big hitting bat.
Like this? This is a big hitting bat.
But you look at these historical bats, these fungo bats going way back. And as we go through the decades, we went to metal, 20 years ago. But the real history is in the wooden bats and the great Chicago bat. Everybody knows most people played with this bat one time or another.
Going through the museum makes this almost like romantic to me, like thinking about the city and, how bootstrappy we are. And all you need is a bat and a ball. I can see why they call this Chicago's game.
We want to thank WGN for doing that. And after that was aired, WGN has contacted us. They want us to work with some underprivileged kids in Chicago again, and we're going to be working with them. George is going to set that up starting next week or the week after, and so we're going to be still working with the young kids in Chicago, teaching them our game. That's the future. A lot of us out here are getting a little bit older, and the game's kind of passing us by, but we got to get these young kids back into the game. And before I talk about the raffle, the last thing I want to tell you is, there's 26 people coming up here with the teams and stuff like that. Let's be a little respectful tonight. Try to get through this without too much noise out there. I know some people get their awards early and all of a sudden they start talking and then the poor people at the end don't get the same respect. Let's try to respect everybody because they've all earned the right to be up here. Remember the 50-50 raffle, the tickets, all that? That's all going to end at 9 o'clock, so if you get a chance, make sure you do that. Other than that, that's it, George. Thank you.
Our president, Ron Kubicki. Didn't he look good on television? Give him a big hand. He looked great, didn't he? I got a lot of calls from Hollywood, and I'm thinking about representing him going forward. One of our original members that we couldn't be here without, Mary Pat McGuire. Come on up. Hall of Fame, super player. She's going to talk a little bit about tonight's raffle.
All right, this is the table raffle, but first, there's a couple items on the basket raffle table that don't have explanations, and I know one of them is a Forest Park VIP basket. There's $50 worth of tickets for the tournament, so that's worth putting some tickets in. And all the baskets are still available. Put some bucket tickets in there, and this is the table raffle, almost 100%. Thank you very much. And Betty, come on up and draw. Betty just flew in from Florida for tonight. She flew in tonight, got here at 7 o'clock, and she's flying home tomorrow because her team's being honored. Okay, table number. Better not be 43. $500.
Table 43, report to the IRS immediately. Congratulations, 43. Okay, let's start the evening. We're going to start it with the Pioneer Division. We have one outstanding Pioneer tonight. Our first inductee in the Pioneer era started playing softball at Reese Park in Chicago. He played for the Lobos. Isn't that a cool name? The Rogues, the Big Banjo Bruins, and was an All-American in 1975. I play softball against his son. This is a great, great, great softball family. The Hall of Fame honors Gildo Coldabella. Gildo! All right, good day.
Before I start thanking everybody, I have to a memory to go back. My brother and I played for 15 years ago together, and he was one of the best hitters in the game. In 1968, we played with the Rogues. We won Clarendon and Kelly Park, but we decided to go play with Moose Camillo. He's also in the Hall of Fame as a coach in Melrose Park because it was only 10 minutes away from home. The other one was an hour drive. The funny part is Moose entered the team in the Chicago tournament, the city tournament, and the first team we play, would you believe it, is the Rogues, the team we left. Well, my brother and I had 5 home runs and 11 runs batted in between us. And Louis Golubic came up to us after the game. He was the pitcher on the Rogues. He said, "We got beat by our own players." Well, my brother never played again because he blew a knee in 69, and he also is gone. I also wish to thank the organization for putting all this together. I wish to thank all the people who voted for me. I wish to thank all the players I played with and the teams I played with. And I wish to thank Bob Campbell for putting in my application every year. And most of all, and most important of all, my wife and family for allowing me to go out and play 4 nights a week plus weekends. And she's still here with me after 59 years. Thank you.
Gildo Coldabella, a classic, as they take their picture over there. Okay, Gildo, great. Veterans, our first inductee in the veterans category, started playing softball on the Sandlot field in Niles, Illinois, after graduating from Western Illinois University, the Leathernecks, where he organized a 16-inch tournament. He went on to play for Auto Mart, the Stray Cats, Coopers, Bud North, and I was with them in 91, Splinters, who won the whole Magilla that year. He was elected to 9 All-American tournament teams and played about 16 years at high-level ball. One of the great ones, let's bring him up, Donnie Bianchi, Don.
Go, baby. Appreciate it. George looked pretty good in that video, too. So I'm a veteran, so some thoughts as being a veteran are a little disappointing at this stage in life. But I wanted to start off by thanking the Hall of Fame board for this honor. Certainly, I've had a lot of reflection here in the last few months since I was nominated. It was quite a run. I also want to congratulate all the past Hall of Fame inductees. A lot of you I played with or against, and I didn't have a chance to congratulate you, but congratulations to all of you in the past. I also want to congratulate the current 2017 class inductees. It's a heck of a group to be involved with. A couple of you I played with. Bobby Russ, I know, was just a young kid when he first started with us on the Stray Cats. And Danny Brichetto and I go way back to when we played in Aberdeen. And there's quite a story there in Aberdeen that he'll tell you later on. I was very fortunate to play in the era I did. Coming off the late 70s when the Bobcats pretty much dominated a lot of the attention in the leagues. We came up out of Desplaines' group. Huey Carmichael's here tonight. He asked me to play with the Runts back when, and then things kind of went from there. There are many, many teams that I played against, and tremendous talent during those years. I gave it up in 92. And throughout the years, I played with teams such as Stray Cats, as Georgie said, and then moved up in through the Cooper's rank, and then played with Bud North. By the way, that was one of the few teams to win three in a row at Forest Park. And then we wound up playing with Splinters, where we wound up winning the championship finally in 1991. I had 6 second places going into that championship. And I can still remember clearly when the dearly departed Egg Zarnick and I and a couple other guys stopped off on the bridge coming back from Cedar Rapids on the bridge at Clinton, and we threw our uniforms and our plaques into the river, Mississippi River. So we knew right then and there that it wasn't going to happen again, and sure enough, we turned around and we won in 91. So I did walk away with a national championship. Things that really I enjoyed about playing was the parks that I played at. So I had the fortunateness, I guess, to play at places like Rand Park and the Pit in Arlington, and I grew up in the Northwest Side. So I played in Palatine and then also in Clarendon, John Hart Stadium, Lou Boudreaux Stadium, played in Marshalltown, played in Kingman. All these fields were wonderful, just impeccably maintained, and of course wound up playing quite often out in Mount Prospect. And Mount Prospect was clearly the league to be in back in the 80s, but nothing could hold a candle up to what was my Augusta, and that was Forest Park. When the Forest Park tournament came around, it was really something to get ready for and to be really, really geared up to win. So those days etch a very strong memory in my mind. And then last but not least, like I said, Egg Zarnick, Kenny Cooper, Mr. Cooper, Terry Moran, some of these guys who have passed on were very, very instrumental in being a part of my life. I played 7 days a week. And if I came home early on Sunday, I wasn't real happy because that meant that we didn't do too well in that tournament. I do want to thank my wife of 34 years. I missed our first date playing ball. And ever since there, she's been very patient over the years when I wound up playing 7 days a week. So thanks, Karen. Appreciate it very much. Love you. Again, thanks to everybody. And thank you very much for this award. Appreciate it.
Don Bianchi. As Ron mentioned in the opening, we lost Miss Porzelt. I just want to read just a little bit of her bio, if you don't mind. Miss Porzelt, who passed away recently, she played in Alsip, Hickory Hills, Oak Forest, Oak Lawn. She played for Ray's Pizza. That was a great team. The Sulky Inn, and was known both as a great first baseman and a great, great person. Again, we want to remember Ms. Porzelt for her great work, so let's give her a big hand. Now, this is a good one here, okay? Our final inductee in the veterans category is from the South Side of Chicago. Got some Sox fans here. He played in the Tavern League and the Cocktail League. After serving in the Army, he helped the Flamingos, probably one of the most famous teams ever, the Senators, the Bandits, and they won many, many games, many, many tournaments. He was known for his fielding, his on-base percentage, and his super lightning speed. Let's bring him up. Mr. Kelvin Jackson. Kelvin.
Well, good evening, everybody. I want to thank the young man that just left the podium for mentioning all of the parks that we played in. So it's evident that I didn't win because they won them all. But anyway, I want to thank the Hall of Fame committee. I want to thank Officer Ware. Where did he go? Officer Ware. The teams that I played against, the teams I played with, my family, two tables. And I want to thank everybody that showed up tonight. Thank you.
Okay, Kelvin, way to go. Don't run too fast now, buddy. You know what? We thought we'd bring up a very good friend of Ms. Porzel. Let's bring up Michelle Liberio to talk about her good friend. Come on up, Michelle. Michelle Liberio. Let's give her a big hand.
Thank you, Hall of Fame, for accepting Beth as an inductee into the Hall of Fame. She really deserves it. Not just by her athleticism, but also by her character. If you played with her and you were on the team with her, she was the big sister. She was always rooting you on even though you were losing. She'd always say, come on, you can do this, we can do this. And Beth always played no matter how hurt she was. She always put tape on her fingers. Sometimes they were all taped and she still played. Before she knew she was inducted into the Hall of Fame, and she put out something to be read tonight, this evening, on Facebook, and I'm honored to be up here representing her and being able to speak for her, and she was happy that I was speaking for her. I'm not going to go into detail about her, the way she played or who she played. It is in the book. They did a very, very nice spread. Thank you for that. We're honored that she had a nice picture and a nice words in here for her. So I will be speaking for Beth now. I'm honored and would like to thank my dad and my brother, Tim, for everything they taught me. This wouldn't have happened without them. They would be very excited for me. Also, my mom and Gloria, who came to so many games, rain or shine. Then we have my family, most of all, Al, my husband, who let me go play 3 and 4 nights a week. Stefan and Kurt, who liked to come sometimes to the games so they could go to the bar. Those were her two children. They didn't get the softball game. I don't even think they remember me changing their diaper on the bowling machine. Last of all, my teammates. You can't be honored without them. Lynn West, who is here in the audience, Colleen Linhart, me, myself, Shear Small Michaelitis, who is in the audience, and many more. I will never forget all of the great times and broken fingers. Kamikaze Night was one of them, not like I remembered much. Beth says, thanks everyone who voted for her in the past. If you'd like to raise your glass and we can have a toast for her. Her final words were, love and peace, Beth. Thank you very much.
Thank Michelle Liberio. Michelle. We have plenty of time. Go ahead and grab a picture, no problem. We had in that Veterans Committee, we had the great Donna Bianchi, Calvin Jackson, and of course, Beth Porzelt, and she was represented by Michelle Liberio. After they take these photos, we're gonna jump up a couple generations. We're gonna go to the 1993 to current. And our first inductee comes from a famous family. They're famous speech givers. I want you to know that. Oh, you guys get that joke. Okay. Our first inductee in the current era started a 16-inch softball career in the 1980s with two Northside neighborhood teams, the Levy, that would be Warren Johnson's great Levy team, and the Jackmen. Oh, yeah, the Jackmen. In 1992, he was a member of the Ice team that won a loaded A Nationals. In 93, he was recruited to play first base for, I've heard this team, Let Us Entertain You Softball. Yeah, for the next 29 years. What? 29 years? Seemed like 100. He started for Licorice, the Laborers, Maxim, Flashback, all 16-inch powerhouses. He has been selected an All-American 10 times, was named MVP at the Forest Park No Glove Tournament twice. That's pretty rare, folks. The Hall of Fame honors my good friend Bobby Russ, Jr. Come on up, Bob.
Thank you, George. First of all, I'd like to thank the Hall of Fame committee for everything tonight. All the people that are getting into Hall of Fame tonight, congratulations. It's a great group. I want to thank all the people for showing up tonight. Great turnout, 500, 600, 700 people. That's what it's all about. I want to thank my family and friends, my wife, Karen, my sons, Ryan, William, and my daughter, Lucy, my brothers, Randy and Marky, and my good friends, the Pagneys and the Munoz, and my mom, who never missed the game. And that, so thank you. I was very lucky. My dad played, so at a young age, I got to watch him play. And I got to watch him play against some of the teams that are going in the Hall of Fame tonight, the Rollers and some of the other big teams. So I fell in love with the game, and I got to play at an early age. I just want to thank some of the guys and teams that I played with over the years because they mean a lot to me, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them. Warren Johnson, as previously noted, started out at the Levy with Warren and Willie Simpson, two Hall of Famers. I moved on to the Stooges and got to play for Michael and Jimmy Spadali, who are here tonight. Fantastic team, fantastic guys. And then I went over and played for a team called Ice with one of my best friends, Pat Caputo, and Ronnie Matriciano, also two Hall of Famers. I played with the Laborers for 1 year with Danny Coco, Lenny Nuzzo, Angelo Licia, Jimmy DeVito, Joey Waitula, all fantastic guys, all Hall of Famers. Then I got to play, had the honor of playing for Rich Melman and the Let Us Entertain You team. Ray Topps is here, great teammate, great friend. Thank you, Ray. From there, Rich kind of got busy with work, and he left softball, and Mike North took over our team and became Licorice. And I got the pleasure to play with Larry Downs and John Westermeyer, who are being inducted tonight. Two great players. It's an honor to be going to the Hall of Fame with you guys. I got to play for a guy named Phil Agilia, like Stan Paddock. I hope everybody could say a prayer for Phil Agilia tonight. He ran the Maxim team for a couple years, and he's not doing real good, and hopefully we could say a prayer for him. I met Pete Raines, great friend, great player. Hopefully someday he's a Hall of Famer. And where we're at now, my flashback team. Gio, George, I know you're here, Wags, and then my all my teammates, which will probably be sitting here in a couple of years. Anthony Tyler, Jeff Hernandez, Ralphie Lawrence, Shane and Denny Lawler, and Mike Meyer and AJ, all hell of great players, and they're going to be here in front of you guys in a couple of years. I'd like to say a couple words about a couple people in my career that are no longer here. El Check passed away. Phil Dunn, Ron Schabinger, who used to run the Jackmen, Tom Egzarnik, a big influence in my life, Eddie Zolna, who many of you guys know, and my father passed away December 1st. Last two things, my brother Randy got inducted in the Hall of Fame last year with Jeff Berger, Keith Philkins, and Ricky Gainkars. I like to be picking third or fourth with that group. Randy, I missed your Hall of Fame. You were the best. I played with you for 20 years. You were the best. I love you. Last but not least, on behalf of the Russ family, my father passed away December 1st. We want to thank you for the support and love we got from the softball community. It meant a lot. He was a fierce competitor. You either loved him or hated him. And I think about him every day, and I love him. This is for you, Dad. Thank you.
One of the great ones. This is a real neighborhood legend here. This is Bobby Russ Jr. Bobby Russ Jr. You know, when we had television in the 90s, it's really, really hard to get exposed to popularity. There's so much competition in sports. There's college sports and pro sports. But in the 90s, this next guy helped us pop out. And let me read it real first. The next inductee in 1993 played with some of the 16-inch softball's legendary figures and helped some of softball's greatest teams win 8 ASA championships, 8 Forest Park, well, you like the number 8, 8 Forest Park titles, many, many league titles. He was the 2006 MVP of the ASA Nationals, a 5-time first-team All-American, is enshrined in the all-time classic team at Mount Prospect. Now, on a key play when he was playing on television, there was a single. He was at first base. He scored all the way from first base, head slide in the home, safe by an inch. People loved it. They put that highlight on ESPN because they saw that on the feed, and that's what helped us. Larry Downs, come on up. God bless you, Larry. The great Larry Downs.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for being out here. This is great. It's a great audience. I'd like to thank the 16-inch Hall of Fame board, everybody who voted for me. This is really a great thing. It's a game I truly love. It's without a doubt the greatest individual honor I will ever receive. It gives me the great pride to be invited into this club of elite players that came before me and made this game great. I was fortunate enough and had the pleasure to play with many of these 70s and 80s Hall of Famers, probably my first 10 years or so. They taught me a thing or two about this game and how to play it the right way. I hope over the last 30 years, I can't believe it's been that long, but that playing major softball, I made all those guys proud today and every day along that way. I'd like to thank my teammates, all of them, from the neighborhood to the majors, because I really didn't play any different on any of those teams. I love you. It was a blast playing with every single one of you. You all pushed me to be better. 6 days a week, 5 months a year, we did this. I'm most proud of the fact that we were ready every day, not just the big games, not the big games or the championships or a 3-day tournament. Those are easy to get up for. I mean, what's not to like? I mean, you're in a championship or you're at Forest Park, you should be ready. 22 league games. Half at 7 p.m., right after work. You're working till 5 o'clock. We're 35 miles from those fields. Try getting there every day, 3 days a week. Win those games. That's the grind. And probably all the championships, yeah, that's, I love them all. But 10 Mount Prospect League Championship titles, 9 Westchester Hodgkins League Championships, that's what I'm proud of my teammates for. They played hard every single day. That's why you're all awesome teammates. We played all the games hard, with passion. That's why you didn't flinch when it came time to win the Nationals or Forest Park. And over all those years, we sure to hell did win a ton of them. And I thank you, all you guys, for that. And you know who you are. I'm not going to name anybody, because I could be up here for 2 weeks. John and Bobby, I played a couple years with them. We won plenty of those championships. My wife, Diane, for allowing me to play this game with the dedication and passion I did it with. I mean, we've been together since 1991. There's a lot of games in between that. My sporto daughter, Kate, who juggles softball and soccer year-round, still finds time to come watch dear old dad play. In all the big tournaments, she brings Jenna, Jillian, Olivia, Abby, Andrew. They all come to the games. Even there under the spell of Forest Park. My mom has always been there for me, everything for me, not just softball. My family and friends, for all the support. They're all here tonight, and so is Burnham. Hall of Famer Don Savage, one of the pioneers, turned 100 years old 2 months ago. He's sitting at one of my tables. Great friend. Ron Kubicki sitting behind me. Not only does he organize all this big show, but for 10 years or so, he organized my team, made sure the only thing I did was play softball. That's all I had to do, just show up. Rick Piavarczyk, who managed everything and put our teams together when we were young. Tom Balick, thanks for pulling me and Rick off the monkey bars at Normandy Park. 1987, to play on some team I had no idea. They were short guys one night. Little did I know was about to happen. Rich Melman, for making the 90s probably the greatest time to be a softball player. He put a charge into softball that carried it at a high level for the next 10 years. His energy, his love for the game, and he did it for all of us. Not just, you know, I had the pleasure to play for Lettuce, but he did it for everybody. I thank him from the bottom of my heart for doing that. Barb and Mike Caputo, they sponsored me in just about every sport I played when I was young. Pat and Billy Devine at the Touch of Class, Al McFarland, Bucks Pit Stop, Euclid Beverage, Fritz Zimmerman, who sponsors me now in my old age, and all the other things he does for the softball world. Bob Rasha, the guy who always been there for me. He gave me 10 great years of unforgettable accomplishments and memories with the 45s. Probably one of the greatest runs in softball history. Tom Zarnik, Eggs, as most of you know him. The most competitive man I've ever met. He was a pleasure to know. He changed my approach to the game. Without question, made me a better player. I miss him. Mr. Russ. I know everybody called him senior. I'm not sure I ever called him senior. To me, he was always Mr. Russ. I think I was afraid of him the first time I met him. All he did was yell at me. I love playing for him. He made others crazy, but it all worked for me. He told it like it was. If you didn't like it, too bad. Critical, but he had your back. And he was the first guy to commend you when all went well. All he ever wanted was your best effort. And for you to succeed, he'll be greatly missed in this game. And he's very missed tonight. My brother and teammate, for being my biggest fan and being right there all 30 years. My Uncle Dan, nobody here to Ireland would be happier tonight. My dad, Larry Downs Sr., many of you knew him. He loved his softball, especially if there was a line on the game. And Uncle Dan was around. Even better if Berger and Matlock were around. He's probably tied with Chris for my biggest fan. He was at every game I ever played, I think. I think even the ones I might have missed. Without question, the man behind the way I played. He was the source of the energy, the desire, the hustle, the passion that I brought to the field. Never let people see you second best effort. Play every game hard, neighborhood or major. You'll never question yourself if you gave it your all. Most of all, his message, play with passion. Love it. This is all for him. Thank you.
Okay, Larry Downs. A little bit over the time limit, but it's okay. Okay. Okay, now let's go to the final inductee of the 1993 to current era. Our final inductee was raised next to Tomahawk Park. That was your park, huh? In Des Plaines, and used to listen to the great sounds of 16-inch softball being played. He went on to play for teams that won 2 SSA majors, 3 ASA majors, and was runner-up 5 times. They also won the Forest Park No Glove National Championships 5 times. Unbelievable. Finished second twice. He was named tournament MVP in 2011. I arm wrestled him once, and he broke my arm. The Hall of Fame honors Johnny Westermeyer. Come on up, Jono.
I'd like to also thank the Hall of Fame and everyone in attendance. Thank you very much. I appreciate your showing up for us, the previous Hall of Fame members who have been inducted, this year's class. Again, I've been lucky enough to play with them. It seems like everybody who's been inducted over the last 10 years I've either played with or against, so that's the reason I'm here. Some of it's talent, most of it's desire. Everybody here who has played this game for such a long time, you need that desire. You have to be out there. You want to compete. And I think that's besides the people you play with, who are the people who get you here, you need to have given up that part of your life, that part of your social being, to actually stand up here and say, hey, I missed a wedding for this. I missed somebody's christening for this. And you're going to get some blowback from family members, but you're going to those games. And they understand you after a while. First, they think you're crazy. My mom probably still thinks I'm crazy. But to make this as short as possible, coaches and sponsors. First, I'd like to thank George Vernazos for putting my name in the hat to get inducted. I do appreciate that, George. Thank you very much. I would also like to thank Rich Wagner from the Turtles, who's really the first organized team. I don't think I had to look in the parking lot and look for my own players. Actually, he had guys showing up, and he was the guy looking in the parking lot. Rich Melman, Joel Zimbroff, Let Us Entertain You, Bob Rasha, the 45s. Vince Foglia, Sage, and Fritz Zimmerman, March Manufacturing. A couple of friends of mine here who I grew up with, first decade, 15 years playing serious ball, Steve Kornstrom and Jimmy Postel. I can't tell you there's two more better people out there who you got to play with. I'd also like to thank the team, the Flashback Corps, that, again, Bobby stole my thunder because he played on the same team. So he knows that everybody that we've played with before have all been almost inducted. These guys will be on the short list for going forward. I'd like to thank Anthony Tyler, Jeff Jibs Hernandez, Anthony Lococo, Ralph Lawrence, Bobby Rush Jr., Shane and Dennis Lawler, and Jake Olson. Again, I love playing with you guys. Probably the funnest team that I've played with. And again, thank you very much for coming. I appreciate your time.
John Westermeyer. Big John. Hey, before we get to the next category, before we get to the manager category, guess who we're going to bring up? You know her, you love her, Mary Pat. Mary Pat, what's up?
Thanks. Okay, silent auction and buckets will be closing soon. Last call for those. And then you can redeem any winnings after the banquet is over in the lobby. Right now, this is the 50-50, $625. Michelle, come draw. I'll read the number, then I'm going to take it out to the T-shirt table. And you can come prove your winner there. Number on the split, the 50-50 pink, 0350326.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Universal Amphitheater. The 50-50, whoever has it, 50 goes to me, 50 goes to you. You got it? Okay. Okay, let's switch now. We're about halfway through, so let's kind of keep it quiet. Keep our aisle open here. Don't take camera shots here. Like I say, keep the aisle clear. My good friend there, whoever it is. Manager category. You know, the guys that run the teams, take the phone calls, get the headaches, recruit the players. Our manager inductee formed a 16-inch softball tournament for his fraternity brothers while he was attending Eastern Illinois University. When he returned to Chicago, he formed Death Wish. After many years of success, oh yeah, go, hey, we love our teams. After many years of success in the park leagues and tournaments, they took third in the USSSAA state tournament, sixth in another tournament nationals, eighth in the ASAA nationals. Had a nice talk with him earlier tonight. Let's bring him up, Kerry Goines. Hey, Kerry.
Yeah. First of all, I want to thank the Hall of Fame committee. Second of all, I want to thank my kids, Shayla and Kerry Jr., because when their mother passed away when they were 10 and 6, I dragged them to every park that I went to. That meant all over the United States, wherever we played. I want to thank my brother, Clifton, who played and coached with me on every team I ever did. I want to thank my Phi Beta Sigma brothers who started off my first Death Wish team. I want to thank Washington Park and its organizers. I didn't know I was going to be in front of James Melton. But without Washington Park, you wouldn't have a lot of black teams. As a manager, you always look up to other managers. So those people was Percy Bobo Coleman with the Flamingos for me, Donnie with the Flashes, Claude Rose with the Safari Tigers. And most of all, my guy used to call him Cool Phil Williams from the Bandits. I loved him because he was always a cool manager. I also want to thank Tom O'Neill and Joe Hoffman because they organized tournaments that I can take my young black team to get them beyond Washington Park. I want to thank all the players that I managed and all the teams. Death Wish, Double Diamond, Death Wish 2, Rolling Dice, 10 Deep, and Dog Pound. I want to give honor to one of the players who played for me with Rolling Dice and Dog Pound, Derek Big D Williams, who passed away 2 weeks ago. And I want to dedicate this to one of the guys who played for me on every team I ever managed. He was a great hitter, and he was a great softball player. Howard Bolin, we call him H. But most of all, he was my friend. And whenever we went someplace, we went to look at softball all the time. He passed away last March. And when I went to Forest Park to look at the games like we did every year, we sat under the scoreboard on field number one and ate tacos and drank beer. But last year he wasn't there, and it was just not the same. I want to thank everybody for coming. I want to thank this year's inductees. It's been great. I love softball, and I just can't do without it. Thank you.
Kerry Goines. So you have to have a manager, you have to have a field, but you got to have an organizer. So let's go to the organizer categories. Our first organizer inductee was assigned to Washington Park as a park supervisor to improve the programs at Washington Park, South Side. He started an 8-team adult leagues on Sunday and later convinced the CTA to move their Sunday league from Grant Park to Washington Park. I didn't know that. That's a big deal. That's a very big deal. He helped convince the Chicago Postmaster to start a 16-inch softball league. Fabulous. Besides organizing the leagues, he started an umpire training and development clinic and created Umpires, Inc. Mr. Melton, James Melton, has passed away, but we have his lovely family here to accept the award. Melton family, come on up.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Jerry Jenkins, and I'm here on behalf of Mildred. Mildred, when you asked me to do this, I said it was an honor. Mildred would like to thank you on behalf of her husband, Jane Melton, for his introduction to the Chicago 16-inch Softball Hall of Fame. Milton says he spent over 30 years playing, officiating, organizing, and most of all, loving softball and basketball. This is truly an honor to accept this award on his behalf. The Melton family and large number of friends, co-workers from the Park District, organizers, and throughout his life, she wants to say thank you.
There's a Chicago legendary family right there, right there. That's Chicago, right there. The Melton family, James Melton. And now another great organizer. Our next organizer formed the Sundowners, the Northwest Men's Catholic 16-inch league, and was president of the Palatine Men's Softball League. He was president of the Chicago Geezers, a league that had teams in the 50, 55, 60, 65 age groups. I could play. These teams competed in senior men's tournaments from coast to coast, from Florida to Canada. He is still playing. He's still managing today. Glenn Grobley. Come on up, Glenn.
You're ready to go, baby. Hey, play ball. Hey, I look around here, I've never seen softball players so well dressed. So, it's an honor. Listen, it's, first I'd like to thank the Chicago 16-inch Hall of Fame, for including me as one of the inductees, and also thank all the other inductees for getting inducted. So, it's a great privilege. You know, I am both proud and yet humble at being inducted into the Hall of Fame. Proud because I have done a lot to continue to keep the great game even greater, and yet humbled by it because I am being honored for something that I love to do. To accept this honor, I need to thank a lot of people, starting with my wife, Mary Ann, who has been with me by my side for 60 years, giving me her total love and support. And she kept score. She kept score at almost every game I played in. I could not have done it without her total support. Thank you, Marianne. Also here tonight is my son, Glenn, daughter-in-law, Christy, who both came in from Omaha, Nebraska, and my daughter, Linda. Both my kids are raised on the softball fields of Chicago and suburbs. I also had a lot of support from former inductees such as Bob Campbell. Bobby, where you at? Bobby's out here somewhere. Frank Lentine, I know Frankie's here too. Mary Kay Monahan, sitting over here, she's been great with me. And Ken Israel. Ken was the guy that really got me going. He became my neighbor, my friend, and he just, as we became friends, he knew all the stuff that I was doing, and he says, you belong in the hall. And so he says, you know, write yourself up, and I'll turn it in, and you know, here we are tonight. So Ken, thank you very much. I appreciate everything you've done. I also want to thank some friends that are here tonight, Ed and Ellie Fabro. I thank you guys for your support. Dave Osborne, the guys we play ball with, thank you for support, and I really appreciate you coming out tonight. While I have organized many leagues and tournaments through the years, there's none I am more proud of than the Sun City Softball Club in Huntley, Illinois. I've been president for the last 8 of the 12 years. This league consists of 240 senior softball players in the ages of 55 to 90. We have 23 teams. We play, softball is played every night from May to somewhere into September, Monday through Friday and Saturdays. So we have it, you know, while a lot of people have retired and have stopped playing softball, guys, I'm telling you, we have one of the best venues in the city, in the suburbs, and it's Chicago at its best. And you take these senior players; they come from all the parks that we know of, you know, Grant Park, Reese Park, Kelly, Melrose, Mount Prospect, Blue Island. It's just great. It is the best venue, and you got to come out and see it. The only problem is, if you want to play there, you have to buy a house. That's all I can say. I want to thank everybody again. I really appreciate the honor, and thank you, Hall, and everyone here. Thank you.
Senior softball, super. Glenn Grobley. Okay, we're getting down to the end, and I want to remind you to, you know, try to keep it quiet and give me an aisle here so we can get the camera in here. Okay, so how many of you remember the great Mayor Daley in Chicago? Okay. Was he one of the best mayors in history? Yes, he was. This is a prestigious award coming up. The Richard J. Daley Award. This guy is incredible. He's from San Diego. He began his 16-inch softball career in 1977. Listen closely. He didn't start here. He brought 16-inch softball to San Diego, California. Yes, he did. When he and his buddies founded O.B. Phils, and they played all over the West Coast. Now, are you guys ready for this? He's been playing for 40 years, 4-0, two times a year because of the weather in San Diego. He plays winter and summer. He's played 80 full 16-inch seasons. 80 seasons. I read up on you. I'm going to embarrass you. This is one of the most famous physicians in California. He's a pediatrician. Let's just bring him up. And I'm glad to have him in Chicago. His entire family's here. Dr. Hank Golombeski. Doctor, he's ready to go, Hank. There we go, Hank.
I didn't do a good clap. I planned that fall, but it didn't work well. I want to thank you all for having me here. I am, as Glenn said, honored and humbled to be here tonight. At the epicenter of Chicago softball. We're outpost in San Diego, trying to keep the game alive in San Diego and the West Coast. It's been a wonderful 40 years. I found out listening to Glenn's speech, however, that there is something to be said about having a wife named Marianne and getting up to the inductee stage. my wife of 51 years has been behind me, and I have to thank her for all of her support as well. Her name is Mary Ann. So if you get a wife named Mary Ann, you might get up here someday. I have a couple of my ball players all the way from San Diego, Steve Pally and his wife Ava, and Robert Lara and his wife Pam, and his daughter, who's my patient, Alana. And they're here all the way from San Diego, and I'm just so touched that they made the trip out here to be with us tonight. One of the proudest moments of my life playing softball was not even wondering if the game we won or lost. I don't remember. But it was when I took the pitching mound this season, and as I got ready to pitch, my grandson was behind home plate catching. My middle son was in the rover spot in center field, and there were three Golden Beskies up the middle, three generations. I was never prouder than that moment. I've been with the same team for 40 years. We have, in the 2000 National, the A Nationals in Chandler, we lined up for the ceremonies to open the tournament. And I was never prouder of my team than at that moment. I looked around and I saw teams from all over the country. But the teams were all uniform. Some Caucasian, some African American, some Mexican American, Latino. And the Obie Phils stood out, not because we were the best team, not by a long shot, but because we were truly a diverse team of African Americans, Mexican Americans, Filipinos, Asians, and Caucasians together. We've been this way for 40 years. The highlight of our year every year is the Yuma tournament, where we go out and we have a lot of fun. We have children, wives, grandparents, families, and the highlight is the barbecue on Sunday. We have the family together. The Obie Phils motto is, we're not just a softball team, we are family. Thank you very much. It's been my pleasure.
That's Dr. Hank Golembeski, San Diego, California. And he didn't bring the warm weather. I don't know what happened there. Another great award, the Frank Holen Award. The Holen Award exemplifies commitment to softball, perfection, and dedication. This year's recipient is Joe Mercadante. Mr. Mercadante passed away a few years ago, but his lovely family is here. Let's bring him up now, the family of Joe Mercadante. And I'm going to let you read your own notes. How you doing, buddy?
Great, thank
How you.
Doing,
boy?
Can I say thank you?
Go ahead.
Thank you. Wow. Just this is I'm very honored to be up here for my father. On behalf of my mother and my sisters, thank you very much. This Softball Hall of Fame is a great honor. My father truly loved the game. He started in the 80s in Hanover Park with my uncle Vince, and they started the Stallions. From there, they went to March Manufacturing, Splinter's March, and the Bud 45s. Wow, this is just a great honor. Thank you very much. I want to thank a lot of his players and teammates and opponents. He's really enjoyed the game. Most of all, I want to thank the reason why probably we're here tonight is his good friend, Fritz Zimmerman, who obviously nominated my father. And I want to thank Fritz for all the time that I spent with my childhood with him and my father's throughout his softball career. Thank you very much. His youngest grandson would like to say a couple words.
Hello, my name is Joey Mercadante, and I would just like to thank you for recognizing my grandpa, and thank you.
That's the grandson of the great one, Joe Mercadante. That was a beautiful speech, wasn't it? That was gorgeous. Okay, now we get to a really prestigious part of our show as well, the Wall of Fame. We've got a few Wall of Famers tonight, but we'll start right on the top. During his 40 years of playing softball, our first inductee played with some of softball greats teams, including the Runts, the Blues, Bud North, Meadows, the Sun-Times, the Shooters, the March team, and Wally Peck's Registers team. He played outfield with some of the legendary players. He was voted MVP of the North-South tournament and was selected as a first-team All-American in 91. My guy, Danny Brichetto. Come on up, Danny. Dan Brichetto.
Let's not do a 4 hour now.
Thank you. We're going to get right back on schedule. This is not going to be a long speech. I don't know how I could follow the last young gentleman here. He brought the house down. I'd like to thank the hall. I'd like to thank Ray and Fritz Zimmerman for nominating me. I'd like to thank my family who's here tonight, my wife, Ellen, my brother, Larry, and all the players that I've played with. I'm not going to list them right now. The Rollers and Blues who are being honored tonight, Huey and Sal Vasta. Donnie, I don't know why you mentioned Aberdeen. This was not supposed to be talked about tonight. Johnny Friel, I hear you. Thank you very much.
I told you gotta love this guy. A beautiful speech. Danny Brichetto. Okay, our next Wall of Fame inductee started organizing pickup softball games after he returned home from his tour of duty in Vietnam and finished college. He played for the Leftovers, the Old Strokes, the Strokers, the Gillette Strokers. He also served as a league commissioner, really, at Clyde Park and Genera Park. He also volunteers at Hine VA Hospital. The Hall of Fame honors Jim Stein. Mr. Stein, come on up.
I think I might know that person. But anyway, I want to thank the Hall of Fame for this because it's truly a great honor to be included with such a great organization and great softball players. One of the things that I think we all share, which brought me back after about a 20-year hiatus, that is the love of the game, the competition, and the friendships that we make over the years. I mean, it's truly one of the outstanding parts of the game. I want to thank my wife, who, when I told her I was thinking of going back to playing softball, her and my daughter said it was a good idea. I just left out the point that it was going to be Friday nights, Thursday nights, and Monday nights, and of course, fall ball. And I want to thank all my teammates who put up with my nonsense for all these years, and also my competitors, because they made me a better ball player. And there's two people that I really would like to thank. One of them is my little buddy and fellow Hall of Famer, Jimmy Quinn. And the other one is Billy Kavanaugh. Jimmy Quinn asked me that almost 30 years ago about playing with the Leftovers. And I thought, go ahead, just give it a try. I just didn't realize I'd be trying with it for 30 years. And then Billy Kavanaugh, who nominated me for this outstanding evening, that at least for the Stein family. And Jimmy and Billy, from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you both, because I know if it wasn't for the two of you, I wouldn't be standing here tonight. So thank you very much.
Okay, that was Jim Stein. Thanks, Jim. Our next inductee played six-unit softball from 1975 to 2005, with his peak years 1980 to 2004. During these years, his teams won many tournaments and league titles. He was considered to be one of the finest defensive first basemen of his era. In addition to having great hands and stretching ability, he had tremendous range, quickness, and softball smarts. His large, still mutilated fingers are a testament to his ability to catch everything thrown his way. And by the way, he is the father of one of my favorite players, one of the top players right now in the game, none other than Kevin Duff of Signature. Let's bring up Kevin's father. Let's do that, okay? The Hall of Fame honors Tom Duff.
I might be the first guy inducted because of his kid. Of course, I want to thank the Hall of Fame Board of Directors for this humbling award. I never really thought it was possible. But I got the call from Ron a few months ago. Oh, wow, it's still hard to believe. Well, I played probably well over 2,000 games in my life. And by the modern sabermetrics, I was probably only tossed out about 417 of them. But there wasn't one game where walking onto the field and crossing the chalked lines that didn't bring butterflies to my stomach. That fresh moment, and I was lucky enough to be a first baseman, my one friend calls them chimpanzee feet. When you get that brand new clincher tossed to you by the ump, it was just a thrill each and every time. I'd pound it into the ground, you'd rub it around your hands, you'd start up the ritual throwing around the infield for the pregame warm-up. There's just nothing like it. Like almost every player, I started out with a neighborhood team, and that was Clockwork in Oak Park. It was a pretty good league, and the home of a good number of Hall of Famers as well. Our Clockwork team grew and grew, but it still took over 10 years before we were able to win that damn title. And winning over our dear friends and Hall of Famer Jimmy Walsh and his brother Johnny and the OJs was second to none. Getting over that hump and over our rivals in 1987 was the ultimate. But my mom, now 88 years young and right over here, probably enjoyed it more than any of us. We went on to win more titles in Old Park, Kaz, and Reese as this Clockwork team, and a good number of other tournaments, none better than taking home the Hammond Park tournament a few times. I'd be remiss not to thank the core guys that made up this Clockwork team. Just bear with me, my brothers John and Jim, Doc Greco, Larry Joyce, Dennis Moore, John Kelly, they're all here, that's why I have to say it, right? Mike Shanahan, Bobby Marino, Bobby Kish, God rest your soul, Bobby. Wally Blase, Billy Gennaris, Frank Weiser, the Romero brothers, Steve Skrine, fellow Hall of Famer Dan Sheik Carmody, who couldn't make it here tonight, and in the later years, even my son Kevin, who I was so fortunate to have won a league championship with and at least one tournament title together. For the top leagues I was fortunate to play in, I have to say the trio of Portage, Hammond, and Clarendon ranked right up there with the best. They'd play the early leagues at 6:30, then the late ones under the lights. What this all comes down to, again, is what is at the heart of our game. It's all about the guys who play it, the respect, camaraderie, loyalty, and having each other's backs. Well, we've always been competitive as hell, and many, many times at each other's throats. But that's a competitive fire we all have to be a champion. It's truly a privilege to be up here, even more so to know that it is not about me at all, about having a place inside so many greats in our game, but really a reflection of every one of the amazing guys I was so honored to play with. All I ever really wanted to be was a teammate, just one of the guys. There's simply no better honor than that. And finally, I want to say a special thanks to my family and friends for all the support and being here tonight, to my mom, my brothers and sisters, and my buddies, and of course, my dear wife, Pam, our son, Kevin, and our daughters, Liz, Kelly and Maggie. Thank you so much, everybody.
Mr. Duff. From my hometown. Our next Wall of Fame honoree started his softball career at Calumet Park after he returned from service in Vietnam in 1968. He started a five-decade career, wow, with the Eastsiders as a pitcher and an outfielder. In 1976, he had three home runs to help his team win the championship of the Vets Tournament at Cal Park. He received the MVP. This is a great player here, folks. The Hall of Fame honors Ron Amazalorso. Come on up, Ronnie. Eastsiders.
He must have practiced that name. I understand it was supposed to be a speech here under 2 minutes, so I didn't really prepare anything for, you know, I got some good stories in the book, but, you know, that's another time. Anyway, I want to start with thanking my teammates and longtime friends who are in attendance tonight, and I love them all, for this prestigious event. I would also like to thank everyone here for showing their support of this annual Hall of Fame inductees dinner. And I want to thank my loving wife, Fran, for the many sacrifices she made and the many functions I was late to during tournaments on the weekends. I also want to thank my daughter, Nikki, who recently started a new job in Seattle, Washington, and could not be here tonight. And I thank God for being able to play the game I love for the last 5 decades. In closing, I would like to say it is an honor and a great pleasure to be inducted into the Hall of Fame family. Thank you all.
That's Big Ron Amazalorso. Okay, we're at the end of the Wall of Fame. This is our last guy, but sometimes we save the best for last. Our final Wall of Fame award started playing softball with his buddies on the Den and the Alley teams at Amundsen Park and Kosciuszko Park. He led Blue Max in hitting when they won the championship at the Cicero Clyde tournament. He's also won a life tournament. He played for the Takers and currently plays with the Crush and the March team. I know this guy well. I like this guy. Let's bring him up. Phil Tondelli. Come on up, Phil.
Thanks, all. George, that's $50. I'll pay you later. Appreciate it. I first would like to thank the Hall of Fame committee and the whole board of directors for putting on this great show and giving somebody an opportunity to come up and say thank you to the people that he's played with, both in terms of teammates and competitors, because a lot of the people that we played with had passion against us, and we played with as much passion, I hope, against them. I'd also like to take this time to talk about two people that are no longer with us, Jimmy Giblin and Bob Sobczewski. I know you're looking down on us, guys, so Sobe and Jazz, here's to you, buddy. I'd also like to thank Rich Chubbs Polfus for nominating me and for just being such a great guy to the point where he does so many things for other people. I really appreciate the fact that he keeps that top of mind, and he really decides to help people, bar none. I'd like to thank my family, who is, they're all here tonight. Some of them came in from California. I'd like to thank my lovely wife, Jen. We've been married 40 years. Honey, I love you. Thanks for putting up with me. I'd like to thank my sons, Danny and Jason, their wives, Anna and Jen, and I've got three lovely grandchildren. So this game has really gotten me to the point where I'm really thankful for having me let me play this time with everybody and having enjoyed it as a family. I'd also like to take this time to acknowledge my brother Tony. Tony started playing softball before I did. He was a better ball player in the family. He played shortstop for the Beavers, and he said, Phil, it's a pretty cool game. You should check it out. So I got involved to started playing some softball with some of my buddies out of college. And I really love his competitiveness, because if there's a more competitive person on this earth than my brother Tony, I haven't met you yet. So Tony, I want to say thank you for being my brother. I love you, buddy. And I'm going to share this with you, pal. Love you. Thank you.
Philip Tondelli, Philip Tondelli. Remember that name, Tondelli. We're getting near the end, and before we bring the teams up, I want to mention that the great Tim Maher is out there in the lobby somewhere. Timmy, you're out there. He wrote this incredible book, We Are Chicago's Game. Beautiful book, just came out. So if you're out there in the lobby on the way out, pick up the book because I'm in it. Okay. Okay. Before we bring the teams up, we're going to bring up one of my buddies from Iowa. This year, we award the Field of Dreams Award to a great guy out of Marshalltown, Iowa. They've hosted 10 national championships, 10 in Iowa. A lot of teams go out there, the Whips, the Touch, Lettuce, Pugliese, Flash. In June, this June, they host the Clincher Classic. Can we bring up my friend Joe Court? Come on up, Joe. Joe Court to receive the award for the Field of Dreams.
Good evening, everybody. The Marshawn South 6th Street Complex is honored to be the 2017 Field of Dreams. First games were played in the South 6th Street Complex in June of 1979. This complex is entirely funded by player donations, concession profits, gate fees, advertising, and donations. No city money was used to build the fields. The 6th Street Complex has been the site of 10 ASA national tournaments since 1980, with teams like the Whips, Touch, Lettuce, Pugleys, and 45s claiming national championships in Marshalltown. 6th Street Complex annually hosts the Clincher Classic Tournament, which is one of the best and the biggest tournaments in Iowa, offering great payouts and good competition. We wish to thank Rick Wickerman, Dave Gray, and Rick Clough, who spearheaded the development of the complex. Marshalltown Parks Recreation Department played a major part in the development and operation of the complex for the first 36 years. The Diamonds are now entirely run by a 12-member Marshalltown Softball Association board. This group will continue to promote and improve softball in Iowa. My personal thanks go to Tim Walker for his help in winning this award. Our thanks go to Chicago 16-inch Hall of Fame for making the 6th Street Complex the first out-of-state Field of Dreams. Thank you.
Joe Court, the big tournament coming up at Marshalltown. Okay, so Theo, I'm gonna let you have a little liberty here. The teams, we're gonna make it crazy, we're gonna have fun. We know it's the end of the night, but we got six teams coming up, and we know it gets pretty wild. There's a lot of crazy music and all that. So we'll just play some great music going up, going down. Let's start our team segment. Let's bring that music up, Theo. Okay, here we go. Expressway to your heart, and let's bring up the six teams. Our first team, formed at the end of the 1976 season, it merged players from Niles, Edison Park, Notre Dame High School. Their first season, they won the City of Chicago Championship. In 1979, they won the Andy Frame Tournament, the Kelly Park Tournament, the North Shore Tournament. They won lots of tournaments. Let's bring them up, the Rollers, the Rollers.
Hello, everybody. My name is Hugh Carmichael. I was fortunate to play with the Rollers for many years until we switched over to the Runts. And there are some words I'd like to say real quick. I would like to thank the founders and board of directors of the 16-inch Hall of Fame for selecting the Rollers for team honors this year. In addition, congrats are due to all the inductees of the Hall of Fame. In a special acknowledgement to Donnie Bianchi and Danny Perchetto for their selections this year. Many of us on the team had the pleasure of playing with them as teammates throughout the years. I would like to say thank you and congratulations to the other teams being honored tonight. We had a chance to play against both the Blues and the Alley during our 10 years at Portage Park, Indian Road, and other locations. They were both tough teams, and they hated to lose. Right now, the Rollers would like to say we are missing several of the very important players that were responsible to the formation of our team. Both of our teammates, nicknamed Eggs, are no longer alive. Tom Zarnick and John Eggert are here in spirit, along with Pat Fullen, Billy Spencer, and Joe Marin. We asked Ray Zarnick, raise your hand, Ray, to fill in for Tom tonight. In addition to those missing, let's say a prayer for Benny Holt, like played on entertainment occasionally, and also to Bobby Russ Sr., who was a tremendous competitor when we were playing against him with the Runts. I would like to say thanks to all of my teammates that are here tonight, especially to Steve Everhart,
and Billy Maurer, who made the trip from the West Coast to be here tonight. Our team was one of the better teams during the years we played. Although the ASA Nationals eluded us, the numerous championships and tournaments we won made us a very tough opponent. We played in what I considered the premier time frame of 16-inch softball. In closing, 16-inch softball has been a major reason for hundreds of friendships that we have established over the years. And I want to say thank you to 16-inch softball for this momentous occasion. Thank you.
The Rollers. Get those pictures, Rollers. Rollers. Did I see the great Warren Johnson? Did I see the great Tiny? Did I see the great Ray Zarnick? The Rollers. Okay, next team, women's team, started playing at Lawler Park. Oh yeah, oh yes. Lawler Park in the 70s, and the pigtail, ponytail, and then what they call the junior miss leagues. They became more experienced and played at parks throughout the southwest suburbs. They won the Why Me tournament eight times, eight. The Bucks and Burn seven times. Oh, I'm sorry, Bucks for Burn, my apologies. And the Best of Western six times. Wow. Can we bring up these beautiful people? The Hangovers, come on, Hangovers. Where are you? Yeah, give me some music for the girls there. That a boy. Come on, dance up to the stage. Come on, dance up.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're happy to say that women get to play this game, too. And I'd like to preface this with, I'm not supposed to be the one giving the speech tonight. That should be our coach, Colleen, but she apparently didn't put the right contacts in. But I am the Italian on the team, so that kind of seems to be a theme around here. On behalf of the team, I'd like to thank the 16-inch Chicago Softball Hall of Fame for providing this great evening and keeping the game alive. Let me begin by saying how honored we are to be joining everyone here that is being inducted tonight, all of those inducted before of us, and all of those yet to come. The women you see standing before you were born athletes. We were the little girls in your neighborhood who grew up playing baseball with the boys until the streetlights went on. Luckily, our park districts ran 16-inch softball leagues for little ones, and that's where we all got our start. We grew into teens and then 20-somethings who still loved playing the game. About 25 years ago when we were three, that's a joke, our women's team was born. We started as a group of young ladies who loved playing the game. We learned a lot those few seasons about teammanship. Over the course of the next few years, we improved greatly and learned to love the game even more. As the years continued to fly by, we experienced so much together. We grew closer with every pitch. We've been to each other's weddings, celebrated the births of our children, mourned the loss of our parents, won championships and tournaments together, and broken way too many fingers to count. Fast forward 25 years to today, where we stand before you. Our knees may creak a little more than they used to, but every time we step on the field together, we play fiercely, we play for one another, and we wouldn't have it any other way. Standing before you are some of the most amazing athletes and inspiring women you'll ever meet. Coach K said, good players inspire themselves. Great players inspire others. These women continue to inspire me every day, and I look forward to the next 25 years. Thank you so much for this honor.
Oh, I love that music, Theo. Play that funky music. That was the Hangovers, in case you forgot. Don't forget our aisle, keep it clear for pictures.
Okay, as we take pictures for history, we're going to clear the aisles here in a second. Boy, we're getting close to the end. We're going to have a big party at the end. Okay, the next team was formed in 1969 and began to play in the A and majors of softball. In 1989, they won the USSSA World Tournament. You see, in the old days, the USSSA was a big deal. From 1969 through 1994, they won over 1,500 games and numerous tournaments. Thanks, girls. And the leagues, metro, state, national levels, including league titles at Mount Greenwood, Newcastle, Mather Park. They played four decades. Here's one of the great names and the great teams of all time. And their great spokesman, Sal Vasta. Let's bring up the Blues. Let's bring them up. Come on up, Blues.
This is our main guys right here. This is our party team. The Blues started with a nice, small, little neighborhood team on the north side of Chicago back in 1971. And we stuck around to the early 90s, won a ton of games. We had a lot of great sponsors, and I can't thank them all enough. Thanks to the Hall of Fame committee for putting our team in, and thanks to these guys. These are my main guys. Thank you.
Vehicle, Sal Vasta. The Blues, our next team, was started in 1974. Let's clear the aisle if we can. We got to keep the aisle clear, or we won't see this beautiful team. Thanks, Ron. Be my usher, buddy. Our next team was started in 1974 with a strong desire to win. They played all over the city and suburbs and always played well. They dominated Mount Greenwood Park from 74 to 92. They won championships in three different decades. Wow, 70s, 80s, 90s, to go along with numerous championships in Mount Greenwood. They also won Arlington Heights, Bensonville, Itasca, Mount Prospect, Roselle, Schaumburg, Wooddale, you're kidding, Hamlin Park. Let's bring them up. The People's Choice. The People's Choice.
People's Choice. You're going to pick the People's Choice? Okay.
Dave Jacobson. I just want to say what an honor it is to be up here tonight, to be able to accept this award on behalf of People's Choice Softball Team. I want to thank everybody with the Hall of Fame Committee for making this night possible, for bestowing this honor upon us. I also want to congratulate all the inductees, the teams, and the individuals. People's Choice Softball Team was formed in the early 70s by the three Duran brothers, John, Jerry, Rich Duran, and Vito Povilaitis of Mount Greenwood Park. Their foursome, combined with other stalwarts from the south side like Gary Ringhofer, Angelo Mocha, Ronnie Peltz, Tom O'Malley, Tom Kevin, gave us a strong nucleus from the south side. I was from the north side. I attended Western Illinois University, where I met John Duran in September of 73. Our friendship formed a union of top players from the south side and north side, as I brought in the likes of Ron Zeman, Derek Singleton, Bill Spicer, Tony Reibel. We always were fortunate. We had good sponsors. John landed our first sponsor, the Chicagoland Plumbing Council. We also were sponsored by Jerry Duran of Tally's Pub in Ford City and Clem Nurseries in Arlington Heights. The last piece of the puzzle was completed by Rich Duran, who attended Chicago State University. He wrestled with and befriended Sam Taylor. They also played intramural softball together, and Rich knew right away he had to have Sam come for play for People's Choice. Sam was a great player. He brought a lot of talent from the inner city to our club. He brought the likes of Drake Jones, Stanley Brown, Odell Humphreys, and many other top-notch ball players. This also changed the dynamics of the club as we were an integrated team. And this was back in the 70s. I don't know of too many other integrated teams back at that time. We made Mount Greenwood Park our home park. We pretty much dominated that league in the 70s, 80s, and 90s. And as was stated before, we went out to the suburbs and we played all over and pretty much fared well wherever we went. It produced a lot of friendships, long-lasting relationships, and it was an enriching experience for all of us. I just want to say thanks again for this honor, and I hope you all had a good night. Thanks.
Isn't that a cool name, People's Choice? Isn't that a cool name? You're darn right. Okay, we're going to clear our aisle here, right? Right here, so we can... Yes, there we go. Our next... Oh, this is going to be a Donnybrook. This is going to be huge, okay? So get ready for craziness. I don't know what song you got there, Theo, but whatever it is, play it. Our next team's roots go back to 1965. They were formed as an outgrowth of Our Lady of Victory Parish's youth-sponsored softball. Many of the original players started playing in the fifth grade at Wilson Park. The original members continued to play CYO softball throughout their high school years and beyond. In the 70s, they won many, many CYO championships and titles at Elk Grove, Trevor, Wisconsin, Windy City tournaments. Can we bring up this great team with about 5,000 people? The Hall of Fame honors the Alley, and here they come, the Alley. Tom LaVar is going to speak for them. Take your time and go crazy, Tom LaVar.
I want to thank the Hall of Fame for including us and giving us this great honor of being included with some of the great teams that have been in the Hall of Fame. I want to thank our wives for putting up with us playing five nights a week and then on the weekends in tournaments. I want to mention two players that are no longer here with us, Jimmy Gorski and Bobby Sobjeski. Sobey was the heart and soul of our team, and he's been sorely missed. I know Phil. Just a little background, we did get together. Some of us played in Cub Scouts back in 1962 when we were 8 years old. Through grammar school, high school, college, been to everybody's weddings, seen their kids, grandkids. And on this stage, we've got folks that have been together from 35 to 57 years, a real testament to us staying together, and the common thread really is 16-inch softball, so we're really grateful for that. So I want to thank the Hall of Fame again. This is a great honor for us. I really appreciate it.
Thanks. Nice honor. Thanks, George. Thanks, George.
There you go, buddy.
Thank you. Who is that gentleman?
Yeah, the guy that hits the ball out of Clarendon about 75% of the time.
Wow, that was...
He's never gone.
That was Danny Zygmunt, and I just heard from Mr. LaVar that gentleman that was speaking used to hit the ball out of Clarendon Park every single day. So there's one of the great teams of the Alley. And look at the outcome. Look at the show. Unbelievable. Thanks, Alley. God bless you. We are down to the final team. We are down to the final presentation. Thank you for being patient. Our final team was formed in 1986. They played at Dunbar Park and next year at Grand Crossing, Ogden Park, and 77th and Jeffrey. In 1993, they went undefeated at Washington Park and placed in the top five in every tournament. They had 2 second-place finishes and a third-place finish in the ASA tournament. That decade, they played in every ASA tournament, including 3 in Iowa, taking a 4th place in 94. Can we bring up the Untouchables? Come on up, guys.
Wow, it's a bunch of y'all. I know it's all y'all here. Well, first of all, I want to thank the committee for this great honor. I want to thank all our fans, all the spouses, for what they had to put up with over all the years and being there and supporting us. I also want to thank these guys, because it wouldn't be no Untouchables without these guys. These guys put their blood, sweat, and tears out there on the field. And I'm proud to call each one of them my brothers. We fought, we argued, but we always competed. And we had fun. And for that, I forever cherish these guys. I started this team in 1986 as I started to come back to Chicago after a brief stint in St. Louis. I came back, I wanted to play this game that I loved so much growing up and playing in the alleys and the vacant lots. Well, the first year we formed this team, we won 1 game. And I remember the team that we beat, because I remember them saying, y'all let the worst team in Chicago beat y'all. Well, after that, we picked up some more players. And we began to be more competitive. And these guys here had the will and the desire to want to win. And we continued to grab more and more great players. And this is what we came up with. I want to let one guy give him a chance to speak, because he said I always left him on the bench. So I'm going to put him in the game, because he had a few words to say. D.
Thank you all for coming out. Good night.
As they say, nice and sweet. That was the Untouchables. Well, that ends our show. The 22nd annual No Glove Nationals, actually the 50th No Glove Nationals is coming this summer, and this is the 22nd annual banquet. We're gonna let the camera roll a little bit because we wanna show everybody on the internet all the great people we have here in the room. So Theo, crank up ZZ Top for me, buddy. We're gonna go out with some great guitar music. We're gonna let it roll. George Bliss, saying, play softball. It's the greatest game in America. Good night, everybody.
when I first started going to Texas, the only thing that was on the jukeboxes in Texas was ZZ Top. And then I'd put the money in, I'd hear it, and my world changed. And then I got to meet Billy and realize that he's another very, very serious archivist type, you know, musicologist type guy. I mean, he's a scholar, you know. All that stuff they do is great and everything, but it's built on a really strong foundation. So it was a very simple decision. Who's going to close the show? Well, I mean, it has to be them.